Hey guys, what is going on? Welcome back. New videos, checking out some new music. Lindsay, what do we got?
Sleeping with Sirens.
Kellen Quinn.
Woo! Kellen Quinn in his own band this time.
What was the last one?
It was with MGK.
Oh yeah, that's right. Love Race. Last
time we checked him out.
That's right. That music video was really sick.
Yes, that's right.
Like, damn.
It was really, really cool. A little emo summer camp.
Yeah, I love the matching jackets.
Yes. I love the matching jackets as well. That was my main comment after watching it.
It was really cool to see them working together again. I said, okay, real quick. In that Love Race reaction, I don't know what the hell's wrong with me. I was like, I would never have seen these two work together. And then after it, I had a bunch of people in my DMs be like, Wyatt, this song. And then the track that everybody was linking me, which had the MGK feature on it from way back in the day, I've had saved. I even own that record, like the physical copy of that. Oh yeah. I was like, what the fuck kind of spacing out? Where, what planet was I? I guess it just been so long since that was back in my Hot Topic days, like a lot of the stuff we talk about here. So I messed that up. But all y'all pointed it out. Nobody was mad about it though. Sometimes everybody gets toxic in the comments, but no one was mad this time. So
that's always nice.
Yeah. Well, my bad on that. I should have saw that coming. But anyways, Sleeping with Sirens. I haven't really jammed them since those days, but we got a track out. It's called Bloody Knuckles. Have you heard anything at all? I haven't heard nothing.
I'm trying to think. No, I don't think I have. The only thing I've heard is people excitedly in our chat the last couple of Fridays being like, oh, you checked this song out yet?
Okay, cool.
Which tells me that at least a few people out there think we're gonna like it.
There you go. That's what's up. So aside from that, this song was requested by some patrons. Big shout out to Cade, Jan, Drew, Susan, Maxson, and Zach for being our patrons and requesting songs like this one for all of us to check out together. That said, Bloody Knuckles, Sleeping with Sirens. Oh, wait, hold up.
Mm-hmm.
That's Sumerian.
Mm-hmm.
Are they new to Sumerian?
I don't know.
Okay. Oh, shit.
Fuck it.
Fuck it. Fuck it. Yo, that cadence is sick.
The fast part?
Yo, I was like, honestly, I was kind of surprised with the chorus. It was like way straighter than I thought it was going to be, considered how like triplet and swing. This is triplet, right? Yeah. So I was expecting it to be like way more swing. It kind of reminded me of, just the rhythm pattern reminded me a lot of that, like Dethrone. Is that the song by?
Oh, by Bad Omens?
Yeah, because it was all triplet like that as well. All right, hold up. Let's go back. Dude, the lead. The guitar there is awesome. I love that. Fuck.
Lay low.
Yeah. I don't know, like MIDI drums getting to be sounding way like more real and real by every year that goes past. But whatever these are, whether that's like them, whether that's the drummer playing or their MIDI, the mix on those drums sounds huge. It sounds really real. It sounds real. If that's MIDI, I would
be impressed.
Yeah. Although I just like some of the MIDI packs that are coming out these days are just like the Get Good drums, and like some of them are just like unrecognizable that it's not a drummer. Because then at the same time, the acoustic mixes are getting so good. Even what Chris Gazelle does with my drum covers, sometimes I get it back and I'm like, fuck, people are going to think these are samples.
Because he did such a good job.
Yeah, like the I don't know, they're closing the gap where the fake drums, well, not fake, but you know, MIDI drums. It is a drum sound. It's a real drum. It's just not being played by a human at the moment in which you hear it or whatever. The MIDI drums are getting closer to real sounding, and the real drums are getting closer to MIDI sounding, and they're kind of meeting in the middle now.
Damn.
Yeah, on the mixes. I've noticed that a lot. Because as the technology improves, they both kind of, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they're both, we're like traveling that direction.
Yeah.
And now they're getting closer and closer together.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. You know. Exactly.
Oh my God.
Oh my God, right?
That was so epic.
Fuck. Oh my God.
Wow, dude.
Fuck. That was really, really good.
Yeah.
That was really good. Yo, okay. Yeah. I'm going to be totally straight with you guys. The last track I remember them putting out, I think it was the last song they did put out, was Leave It All Behind.
Okay.
I only know the name because the screen, you see it there.
The thumbnail, yeah.
And we checked that out and we didn't post the reaction because I wasn't whatever. But holy shit, this song.
This was super cool.
Like damn, bro. More of that, whatever that is, whatever secret sauce. Let's go. That was awesome.
Yeah, his voice is so like epic and like multi-dimensional. Like, you know, he's been like singing for so fucking long.
Yeah.
Because he's just like, there's so much happening. Like when the chorus starts and he's like, pack your bags. Like the way he says pack, I'm like, it's like an unexpected like half scream. I don't even know.
Yeah.
I don't know how to describe it. But
yeah.
When I was young, like when Sleeping With Sirens was really, really popular, like in like the Warped Tour time, I was not into any of the bands with high voices.
I know. Yeah, you
that's when
it.
I was like, you know, edgy fucking emo girl. I'm listening to Suicide Silence. Like, I don't care about Kellen Quinn. Like, but now as an adult who's way more objective and interested in other types of music, like that was super, super good.
Yo, I loved Sleeping With Sirens back in the day.
Yeah, that's totally a band you would love.
I know,
right?
I was totally super into the high voices.
Yeah.
Cause you know
like, all of them basically, right?
Yeah, well, honestly, in my household growing up, my parents didn't listen to a ton of music, but the music that my dad was listening to, especially just being like Canadian from outside of Toronto, there was a lot of Rush on. And I got used to that. There was Rush and there's AC/DC, and like when everybody was hating on the higher voices, it wasn't everybody, I shouldn't say that, but there was like a group of like among the friends that I had, there was a group of metalheads who considered themselves too cool to want to listen to a high to listen to that sound. And I just didn't understand it because I was like, yo, they're just doing Rush today. It's fucking sick. What's the problem with it? You know what I mean? I didn't get it. Like King for a Day, like all like Vic stuff, Kellen stuff, both those bands. I remember there was a Skylit Drive. That was another.
Oh,
I fucking love a Skylit Drive.
Yes.
So let me go here. So Sleeping With Sirens for me, the records that they really got me with was, Kick Me was sick. I remember that song. That was like a one-off, I think. I think that was just a single that came out between records. But where's their discography here? This one, With Ears. This record, With Ears to See and Eyes to Hear. This record was on my snowboarding playlist. There was two records. There was two bands at the time. It was Drugs and Sleeping With Sirens. And I snowboarded a few seasons straight just jamming these. I don't know why. There was something about it. The Bomb.com V2.0. That song, like, listen to this. Like, this just...
Okay.
Like every time that hit, it just, oh man, let's go. That was a sick track.
Yeah.
And then this record here, they lost me at Feel a little bit. I didn't get big into Feel.
You know what though, back to the with Ears to See or whatever.
Yeah.
I remember the James Dean song, If I'm James Dean or Audrey Hepburn, because that was so flipping popular at the time.
Absolutely. Yeah. And then there was off of this record, let's cheers to this, there was If You Can't Hang. Oh my God. Oh my God. There wasn't a playlist on the Hot Topic player at the store I worked at the time that this wouldn't pop up on. Like, it was crazy, man. I heard this so many times. This is a great song. Oh, that guitar, shit. Yeah. Yeah, it's going back a minute. But no, this new track. Let's stay focused, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Damn.
New track.
Bloody Knuckles. That was awesome. I hope that we get more like that. I hope that this is the start of a new cycle and we got a bunch of tracks to be checking out here in the future that are along these lines. Because it was like a really sick balance. Like we had, you know, it was like there was some metal, you know, there was a lot of like punk rock kind of feel to it.
Yeah.
We had his like incredible screams. We had like a really well balanced chorus. The breakdown was unreal. It was kind of like a breakdown that reminded me of like a lot of what's I was gonna say Beartooth's been putting out, but I guess it's a little bit older. Bear, kind of like a rocky breakdown, you know?
Yeah,
what I mean,
like not quite a rock down, but
yeah, whatever. Yeah, I don't know the labels. Know. You know, whatever, but yeah, overall that was a sick track.
And like the verses were really good too.
Yeah, for
like
real.
The verses were just as good as the chorus. I feel like I enjoyed it from beginning to end.
100%. It was kind of tight for the verses and they really opened up for the chorus, and the way it just really about, yeah, I don't know, I'm just basically seeing the same thing over. So I guess that's at the point where we'll call on the video. I hope you guys all enjoyed our reaction to the song Bloody Knuckles by Sleeping With Sirens. This reaction was requested by Cade, Jan, Drew, Susan, Madison, and Zach. If you want to become a patron so you can request songs like this one for us to check out, you can find our Patreon link down in the description. You can support the channel by checking out the merch link. Thank you guys so much for watching these videos. We'll see you all very soon with something new.